In this video, I am going to explain muscle anatomy around greater trochanter. Greater trochanter is big bony bump on femur. This is very big part of bone. You can palpate that from above your pants. It's very superficial and it's big. It's easy to palpate. Around greater trochanter, there are many muscles. I will explain muscle anatomy first. Then on second part, I'm going to explain why this part is important. Let me explain from this muscle. This is gluteus medius. Gluteus medius, it attaches to superior part of greater trochanter. One more muscle. You don't see that, but there is muscle deep to gluteus medius. This is gluteus minimus. This muscle also attaches to on superior part of greater trochanter. So basically, glutes muscles, gluteus medius and gluteus minimus attach to greater trochanter. Then let's go to deep part of hip joint. This muscle is piriformis. Piriformis, very famous hip muscle. This muscle originates from sacrum, then it goes to greater trochanter. Next muscle. This one, this tiny one, this is gemellus superior. Gemellus superior. Gemellus means gemina, twins, right? There is gemellus superior. There should be gemellus inferior. Where is inferior? That's this one, this is gemellus inferior. Okay, gemellus superior and gemellus inferior. These muscles attach to around greater trochanter. If you open anatomy book, it doesn't say insertion of these muscles are greater trochanter. However, they are pretty much close to greater trochanter. Good to know. Between these twin muscles, there is this one. This is obturator internus. Obturator internus. If there is internus, there should be externus. Indeed, there is obturator externus. Obturator externus is deep muscle. It's from anterior part. Thus, you don't see that in this picture. Imagine, there is obturator externus attaching around greater trochanter, like that. Then, last one from deep muscle. That's this one. This is quadratus femoris. Okay, quadratus femoris. These tiny muscles, piriformis, gemellus superior, inferior, obturator internus, externus, and quadratus femoris. These muscles are considered as deep lateral rotators, deep lateral rotators of hip. They all attach to greater trochanter or close to greater trochanter, like this. See that? You know, this attachment is very important. This landmark is very, very important. Then let me explain one more muscle. That's here. This is slightly inferior part and slightly anterior part. This is surprising. This is vastus lateralis. Vastus lateralis is part of quadriceps. Surprising, right? All the muscles except vastus lateralis are hip muscles. Think about it. Gluteus medius, gluteus minimus, piriformis, quadratus femoris. They are all hip muscles. However, vastus lateralis is thigh muscle. That is knee muscle. This muscle also attaches to greater trochanter. Why is this place so important? Then let me explain that. As I showed you, there are many muscles around greater trochanter. Then, what can you apply for your clinical experience, for your exercise, for your self-care treatment? Now, if you know what kind of functions these muscles do, you can apply for your field. Think about gluteus medius. What kind of movement does gluteus medius? Does abduction. Abduction, then there are many other movements like flexion, extension, internal and external rotation. Plus, that can do pelvic movement. That can do anterior tilt, posterior tilt of pelvis. So is gluteus minimus. Gluteus minimus also does abduction, flexion, extension, internal rotation, and external rotation. So, what if these glutes muscles get tight? That inhibits hip movement drastically. And plus, pelvic movement. That can inhibit flexion, extension, internal rotation, and external rotation. That's a lot of movement. Then, what kind of movements do external rotators? That does external rotation. So if these muscles get tight, that inhibits for internal rotation. Why is that? Because function is external rotation. Then that inhibits the other movement, right? Internal rotation. Then some of these muscles do other movements like hip extension, hip abduction. Then that inhibits the other movement. Some muscles do extension. Thus, flexion is inhibited. Some muscles do abduction. Then adduction is restricted. That is why tension around greater trochanter is freaking important for healthy hip movement. Then for gluteus medius and gluteus minimus, that is important for pelvic movement. Oh my gosh, very important place. Now, what about vastus lateralis? This is knee extensor. If this part, inferior part of greater trochanter gets tight, that may affect for vastus lateralis. What is that? That is knee extensor. Thus, maybe knee flexion can be restricted. Why is that? Because vastus lateralis is just below greater trochanter. See, now you understand why this part is very important. Not only that, you can suggest myofascial connection from greater trochanter for other part. What do I mean? Like, if your vastus lateralis is tight, maybe this tightness may affect for gluteus medius, gluteus minimus, or maybe for deep lateral rotators. Vice versa, if your gluteus medius is tight, there's myofascia, of course, this tightness may affect for deep lateral rotators or vastus lateralis, very important place. As I said, greater trochanter is very superficial, very big. Thus, you can palpate this bone very easily. Now, you can easily palpate where tension is. If you find tight place, you can do self-care treatment. You can do stretching. When you feel tightness, there is possibility for release. That is why knowing anatomy around greater trochanter is very, very important for healthy hip movement plus healthy pelvic movement. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.